Good morning students. So this is a mechanical properties of the solids video, second video, class 11, intermediate first year. So now elastic limit. So what is the elastic limit? I am write the first definition. The maximum stress within which a body can regain its original size and shape after the removal of the deformation is called elastic limit. So here, let us take, this is a one body. Right, I am taking one body. So when the external force or deformation force capital F is acting. So when this deformation force is acting on per unit area A, the stress is produced. So this is maximum stress within the body can regain its original shape and size after remove the deformation forces. Okay, the maximum stress, when the deformation force will be removed, it is a comeback to original shape and size. So that limit is called elastic limit. So after elastic limit, what happened? After elastic limit, their object is not come back to their original position. Okay, after elastic limit, the object is not come back to original position or original size. So when the deformation force is applied, the stress will be acting. So this deformation will be removed. So it is come back to original position. The maximum stress is called elastic limit. So here, especially according to Hooke's, it is explained their elastic limit properties. So according to Hooke's, within elastic limit, always stress is directly proportional to strain. So according to Hooke's is explained their elastic limit or elastic properties. According to Hooke's, within the elastic limit, always stress is directly proportional to strain. So this statement is called Hooke's law. So that is, here I will write, stress is proportional to strain. So that is, stress is equal to K into strain. And stress by strain is equal to K. So this equation is represent Hooke's law. So the stress by strain is equal to K. So where, what is the K? K is equal to proportionality constant. What is the K value? Their K is called proportionality constant. So here, this proportionality constant K is called modulus of elasticity. What is the K? K is called modulus of elasticity. So that is, K is equal to stress by strain. The stress is directly proportional to strain within the elastic limit is called Hooke's law. So there, K is equal to proportionality constant. That is, K is equal to modulus elasticity. So what is the definition of the K? Here I am writing the definition of the K. The modulus of elasticity, K of the material of a body, stress in the body to produce unit strain. So this is called modulus of elasticity. The material of the body, the stress in the body to produce unit strain. And here some properties. K, first point, K is depends on nature of the materials. K is depends on nature of the material, first point. So K is always depends on the nature of the material. And second point, so temperature and impurities also depends. Temperature and impurities also depends. So it is independent of, it is independent of dimension of the body. It is independent of the dimension of the body. So what is the units here? Units. So it is units Pascal. What is the SI units? SI units is equal to Pascal. CGS Pascal means Newton per meter square. We know that very well. Newton per meter square. CGS units. What is the CGS units? Dyne by centimeter square. What is the dimensional formula? Dimensional formula M1 L minus 1 T minus 2. M1 L minus 1 T minus 2. So therefore, their elasticity of modulus, modulus of elasticity or elasticity of modulus is equal to stress units. Stress and elastic modulus, both are same units, both are same dimension formula. So according to Hooke, the stress is directly proportional to strain. Next, stress strain curve or behavior of a metal wire under a increasing load. So very, very important, especially in the IPE purpose. Here, let us take, consider a metal wire. So this is one metal wire. Consider this is one metal wire here. This is metal wire hanged with rigid support. One end is hanged with rigid support. Another hand, their mass M is hanged. So here, what is my concept? The load here, the load will be increases. Let us take their load will be increases. So you observe what is the behavior of the metal wire when the load will be increases. 2 kgs, 3 kgs, 4 kgs, 5 kgs. So the load will be increases. What is the behavior of the metal wire? So that is explained by using one graph. Thus, that graph, that curve, it's give stress strain curve. So in this case, here I am taking one graph. So it's very, very important. So I am taking x axis and y axis. In the x axis stress, I am taking in the y axis strain. Okay, in the x axis stress, in the y axis strain. So here, first one, first. So first, it is having the maximum 5 kgs weight. Okay, what is the capacity? 5 kgs. So now, so in this wire, first it is a put, please listen. First, in this wire, I'll put only 2 kgs weight. What is the capacity? 5 kgs. So now this 2 kgs weight is removed. What happened? It is a come back to original shape or size. Yes, it is come back to original shape or size. Now their 3 kgs will be increases. Their wire is very small elongation. The length is increases very small. This 3 kgs is removed. It is come back to original position. And when the 4 kgs is placed, so this wire is elongation is more. When this 4 kgs is removed, it is a come back to original position. So up to 5 kgs, what happened? Their wire is elongation. Now this removed the weight, it is a come back. So in this stress and strain, what is your observation? So the stress is increases, that is a 2 kgs, 3 kgs, 4 kgs, 5 kgs. The stress is increases, the strain also increase. That is, here the length, thickness, diameter will be decreases. So therefore, in this stress and strain, here this is a O2A. So this is a original position O, here this is a position. In the O2A diagram, so what happened? So in the O2A diagram, stress is directly proportional to strain. Stress is directly proportional to strain. It is obeys to Hooke's law. What is your observation? The stress is increases, automatical strain also increases. So in this diagram, in this graph, O2A is indicated. The stress is directly proportional to strain. So therefore, the Hooke's law is obeys to. So this A is called. What is the OA? The A is called proportionality limit. A is called proportionality limit. What is the proportionality? In the proportionality limit, it is obeys to Hooke's law. So now here, so at the 5 kg is maximum. So this is a 5 kgs. Now is just 10 grams. Only 10 grams is adding on this wire. Is it broken or not? Only 10 grams. Very, very small mass. So when the very, very small mass will be increased, their wire is not broken because this is a 10 grams or let us take 1 gram, 2 gram, 3 grams. Very small mass will be adding this wire, their wire is not broken. Okay, so here suppose the 1 gram and 2 grams, 3 grams. So when the 1 gram, 2 grams, 3 grams will be increases, their wire is, in this case, their graph is shows, so only after 5 kgs limit, their graph A to B like this, A to B. So in the second one, A to B, what is your observation? In the A to B, 1 gram, 2 gram, 3 grams you can add in the A to B, stress is proportional to strain. Stress is proportional to strain. The stress is increases, automatical strain also increases, but it does not obeys to Hooke's law. It does not obeys to Hooke's law in the region AB region here. In the AB region, it is does not obeys to Hooke's law, but the body is come back to original position. When the load will be removed, this is a 1 gram, 2 gram, 3 grams will be removed. It is come back to original position. So this is AB is indicated. AB is indicated. That is B point is called yield point. What is the B point is called yield point. B point is called yield point or elastic limit. Elastic limit. In this elastic limit, the stress is directly proportional to strain, but Hooke's law is not obeyed. The elastic limit, this corresponding stress, the corresponding stress is called yield strength. So what is the stress? Their yield strength. That is sigma y. So here I am taking in this graph. So this B point is sigma y. And so now 1 gram, 2 grams, 3 grams up to 10 gram. It is a maximum elongation. Maximum elongation. Suppose let us take is placed in 1 kg. What happened? The wire is broken. Wire is broken. So in this 10 grams, 20 grams, 30 grams, suppose in 1 kg is extra, that is 6 kgs. The 6 kgs, the wire will be broken, for example. So in this one, 10 kgs, 10 grams, 20 grams will be increases. What is the behavior of the wire? This is the behavior of the wire. So here, this is the behavior of the wire. Okay, so B to D, up to B to D, their behavior of the wire. So in this B to D, what you observation? Okay, when the stress is applied very, very small, the strain is very fastly. Stress is here, what is your observation? So in this one, so in the B to D curve, the load increases. The load increases further. The load increases further. Strain increases rapidly. Strain increases rapidly over for small changing of the stress. So this is a diagram here in this one, B2D. So here in this B2D, I am taking one point capital C. In this B2D, in the curve, I am taking one point. So at this point C, when the load is removed between B and D, when the point C, the load is removed, the body does not come back to original position. So at point C, what happened? Load is removed. Load is removed. So let us take already 5 kg is there. Okay, suppose here 500, 50 grams, 50 grams or 500 grams. So at this point, when this 5 kg, 500 grams will be removed, so I am taking at point C. So it is not come back to original position. So here it is having this position, not original position. It is having, we touch on the strain one point. So this is called as, this called as permanent set here, O2C. So O2C is called permanent set. So in this permanent set, it is a maximum. It is a maximum. So after permanent set, their load is increases very small. Okay, let us take 600 grams, 700 grams or 650 grams. Load will be increases very small. The strain is rapidly increases. The strain rapidly increases, finally reached capital E point. Finally reached capital E point. At the E point, their wire will be broken. Here there is a maximum. Let us take 6 kg is placed, hanged. So what happened? The wire will be broken. So this is is called breaking point. In the breaking point, what happened? Even very, very small stress will be applied. The strain is very large. So it is break the wire. So that is point is called breaking point. So if large deformation occurs, if large deformation occurs between elastic limit and breaking point, the materials is a ductile. The large deformations between elastic limit B and breaking point, so that is materials is called ductile. So what is the examples of the ductile examples? Copper, silver, gold is a ductile materials. And if deformation is very small, if small deformation between B and E, so that is materials is called brittle. The deformation is very small. For example, glass and ceramic is a brittle. So this is capital E is called, so what is the point? Fracture point also. Okay, so the capital E is called fracture point. That is, D is called on the graph ultimate tensile stress. Tensile strength sigma u. D is called ultimate tensile stress here. In this one, D is called ultimate tensile strength. So this is a stress strain curve. The breaking stress is equal to the maximum stress at which the wire breaks is called breaking stress. So what is the breaking stress? Maximum stress at which the wire breaks. So that is called breaking stress. So breaking stress BS is equal to breaking force by initial area of the cross section. cross section initial area of the cross section. So this is called breaking force. And so due to own weight, another point, due to own weight, okay, due to own weight, okay, very long wire is vertically suspended, is a breaking, breaks. So that is L is equal to formula breaking stress by rho g. Breaking stress by rho g. Here let us take for example, so this is a, so one object, okay, the maximum length L, yeah, maximum length. So due to own weight, their length will be broken. So that is L is equal to breaking stress by rho g. Rho is equal to density, okay, density of the material or density of the wire. G is equal to acceleration due to gravity. Elastomers. Here some substances is not obeys Hooke's law. So the stress strain curve, the different materials, difference. So here some are is not obeys to Hooke's law. For example, natural rubber, tissue of aorta. So what is the elastomers? So which substances have low Young modulus. What is the Y? Y is equal to Young's modulus. Low Young modulus and consequently can have large value of strain. Okay, large value of the strain. Where the low Young modulus, the substances is called elastomers. So an elastomers after being stretched return approximately original length. After stretching, it is give original length. So in this, for example, tissue of aorta, what is a graph? So this is a graph. Okay, here stress and here strain, okay, the stress and strain. So this is a graph of tissue of aorta. So in this one, what is your observation in this graph? The Young modulus of elastomers is very small. Why is very, very small? The strain rate is very slow. Slow strain rate. So this is elastic tissue of aorta is a graph. So clear that the elastic region is quite large. This is the elastic region. In this one, the graph is explained, the elastic region is quite large. The material does not obey to Hooke's law. So this is called elastomer. So this is end of the topic. So thank you, one and all.